of Fame. It's an unbelievable, incredible honor to be here today. And I'm so proud and deeply honored and humbled at the same time to become part of this tennis family and to join Kim, Andy, Steve, and posthumously, Pete Braden. Congratulations. You are such great champions, each in your own field of tennis. You gave me many moments where I was able to admire you after my career, because you guys are much younger than I am, so I had time enough to admire you guys. And especially Kim, I admired your splits. But the press party in your doubles match last week at Wimbledon, that beat everything. That was so hilarious. How magic and powerful is tennis? I think the answer can be found right here at the International Tennis Hall of Fame. I was totally impressed and totally overwhelmed yesterday when I entered the museum. There is so much culture, so much history preserved in this place. This is by far more than I expected. I'm so fortunate to have tennis in my life. It's been magic and powerful to me as well. At the age of 6, I picked up my first racket. I was still running around the courts, and as a teenager, I looked up at tennis icons and role models like Chris Evert and like Martina Navratilova. They were my source of inspiration. They gave me my dream of becoming a top player, and I wanted to be like them. Thank you, Chris. That means the world to me. But at the age of 14, when I was fighting cancer, it looked like that dream was shattered. That it was shattered to pieces. I went back on the court in my hospital chair, and my friends raced me around so I could play a rally on the court. But a match, there was no way I even thought about playing a match at that time. And I thought I would never play again. I wasn't aware of wheelchair tennis until Peter Sagers, my first Dutch coach, introduced me to my new heroes, Brad Parks and Randy Snow. They brought over the game to Europe, and I was so impressed how they raced around the court when I was still sitting in my hospital chair, just getting out of it. But I was so inspired by these guys driving their own chair rather than being pushed around. And thank you for that, for bringing wheelchair tennis across the globe. Thank you for that, Brad. I was so impressed how that time went by in the beginning. And after 6 years of table tennis, I picked up my racket again and I went for wheelchair tennis, the love of my life. Early in my career, I traveled to California for the first time. 6 weeks to train and to play tournaments, and I was so excited. I arrived at LAX on the other side of the world, on my own, and I picked up my huge fancy hire car, and off I went. On my own, proud, committed, and eager to learn from the best US wheelchair tennis players. I wanted to be the best wherever it would take me and whatever it would take. Behind the wheel on the 6-lane American highway, I was still exploring the new car, how everything worked, how the hand controls operated, until a traffic jam all of a sudden popped up in front of me. And I pushed the hand controls in as hard as I can, but instead of braking, I accelerate. Because the pedals work opposite of how they work in Europe. So in a split second, I pull the car onto the hard shoulder, overtake 3 cars, and pull it back on the highway. And I continue my trip. But still, I feel on top of the world. While my heart beating was 100. success, but there's also failure. And there's celebration, there's disappointment, there's resilience, there's dedication, but the glass is always half full, especially when you're a daughter of a bar owner. And always aiming for goals, but be thankful with less. That was important to me. And tennis has made me to who I am today, and for that I am so grateful. I want to thank my family, who's represented here by my elder sisters, Marianne and Will, and they were always there to support me, encourage me, and to taxi me wherever sport would take me, before I was at danger on the road on my own. Justin, you've not been a part of your father's and mum's joint tennis years, but we already liked shoes at that time as well. But I hope you get a good impression now of what tennis means to us. You mean the world to us, darling. To my coaches and trainers, a big thank you. But Mark, especially, remain the biggest part of this journey together. And first as a coach, later as a husband, a journey full of learning, laughing, and love. Mark, you meant and will always mean everything to me. Australia at the beginning of the year, he told me this induction is going to feel like a wedding.